Hey guys, welcome back to Grizzly Valley. Today is a very long episode and it's also the one which I probably put most time in, and I'm actually not even showing all of the time lapses which I have of this because there are definitely some boring and, well, very long parts, and it would make this already quite long episode really huge, and I do want to keep it somewhat central. Basically though, what I'll be working on in this episode is a small Japanese pavilion which I'm doing over here, which was very much an experiment to see if it's really possible to get different roof shapes and actually make them look somewhat clean and be happy with them with the pieces that we have in the game at the moment, and really be able to make roof shapes that we don't currently have. Like, obviously I wanted to make a Japanese pavilion, though it's much more commonly Chinese. I just really figured it would fit in this area quite well, but really one of these Asian pavilions with these roofs curving upwards toward the side and having these tiled roofs that really have a lot of detail on them and flow from like a pointy middle point to the curving sides, as you're probably all familiar with. And it's something which I just wanted to try to see how much you can really do with the pieces in game. Obviously, theoretically, it was always possible to do this. I just wanted to see if it's really somewhat practical as well, which it turned out not to be. This is actually the second version of this pavilion, and I cut out a lot of time lapse just for this pavilion because it took many hours to make it in the current way it is. Looking back, I should have probably also just built one quarter and then just cloned that quarter, but even then it's not so easy because you'd have to have every single beam exactly be in the right spots and correspond with the beams on the side, or you'd have like they wouldn't really connect seamlessly. So it was really hard to get these beams to be exactly where I wanted to be. It's also something that, looking back, is not really all that practical, because in the next episode, next update of the game, there will be like 3-axis rotation for objects that you place, so I definitely made it a lot harder for myself here than I should have. But yeah, it was just an experiment which I wanted to try, and that really goes for this entire episode in general. The reason why it took me so long to record this, well, there isn't really one central reason, but one of the reasons for it is really that it's a bit more experimental. I am building Japanese buildings, but completely differently than I was doing it before, and I really wanted to make it a lot more realistic and try to achieve a clean look, but a look which I haven't yet had in the Japanese area or the game in general. You'll see later on what exactly I'm talking about. But yeah, that's one of the reasons why this episode took quite a long time. Another reason is actually that I haven't played the game that much lately, and this episode alone was recorded over the past 2 weeks. Like, partly I couldn't really find time to play the game, and on the other hand, I've also just been doing other things in my life, and also I've been addicted to Rollercoaster Tycoon 1 again for the 1000th time in my life. I might make some time-lapse videos of that, but this is probably not the best place to talk about that. But yeah, Rollercoaster Tycoon 1 is basically what I've been spending too much of my time with lately, and I couldn't really find any inspiration for this park or this section of Grizzly Valley. I sort of had a writer's block in that sense, and it only really got lifted once I started making some Japanese buildings in this new way, and after many failed attempts, actually found a style which I quite liked and went with for the remainder of this episode, basically. So yeah, that's something you'll see in a second as well. I also wanted to make sure to get a nice little layout over here, make this a bit more park-ish. It's definitely not as much as I would love it to be. It's definitely not very Japanese garden-esque, but still make this area somewhat larger and have some more paths in here, more like a theme park. I also felt that this was one really good place to have this little seating area and a small park where people can just walk around and I don't know, just look around in a more quiet way, since it works quite well with how the park in general is laid out, and especially how this coaster looks from over here. This is definitely one of these shots, a sightline almost, toward the coaster that I wanted to keep clear, because the double loop is obviously quite a landmark-ish coaster element. I just really wanted to keep the area around the double looping quite open and let people be able to see the double loop as you're approaching it from both of the directions. So whether you're coming from the main streets or coming from the rest of the Japanese area, the double loop should be quite a prominent thing in this part of the park. So that's also why I wanted to keep it quite open. This is actually one of my favorite apple trees-ish things. I was trying to get this sort of apple tree idea by just raising flowers onto a small wooden post to make a red tree. Sadly, we can't really have any cherry blossom trees, but I'm still quite happy with how that turned out. Anyway, this is where I'm actually starting to work on what is going to be the remainder of this episode and what definitely took the most time, which is a facade of Japanese buildings. And it's gonna require a bit of an intro because it's hard to really describe them by just saying Japanese buildings. First, what I should really say is that it's hard to talk about Japanese buildings in a sense that there is no archetype Japanese buildings. There are like the farmer type houses, the real merchant townhouses type things, the large villas like houses of the samurai, the temples of course, which is quite different as well, and like different regions and different times have all sorts of different architectural styles. And what I really wanted to try here, which is something that I hadn't really done yet, or at least not in a way that I was happy with, is try those more merchant type townhouses. So quite narrow houses that really move forward quite a bit, almost like houses in Europe, Amsterdam for example, very narrow, somewhat high houses that go on for quite a while behind them, and are really the merchant type house. So no real big temples or large galleries or anything of that sort of sense, but a more urban type house. But the style of the buildings is not the biggest change about these in general. I would definitely say that the roofs are something that is most iconic, at least for these buildings, because it's the thing that I took the most time to tweak and get to be happy with. Because basically, I was just building Japanese buildings over and over again with different styles every now and then just to see what I would like, and I didn't really come up with anything good in the entire span of 2 weeks. And finally, I built a house which was nearly a clone of the one which I'm making at the moment, and I felt it could work quite well. It's basically, it's different from the other Japanese buildings I have at the moment, obviously in the roofs, since I wanted to go for the brick sandstone roofs instead of using the blue roofs in the game because they don't have the right shape. And I also didn't want to go for the red signs because Japanese buildings have tiled roofs and not wooden roofs, or at least the urban ones don't. There are quite some thatched roofs, for instance, in farmhouses, but I really wanted to get a more tiled roof look, and the red wasn't quite as good, and I feel that this brown color at least is somewhat more close to the black color that most Japanese buildings in real life have. And aside from that, I also went a bit more into the walls and details of buildings. So instead of trying to make it look as if it were similar to a Japanese buildings by placing many windows onto them, I really wanted to make those typical Japanese walls and windows in a sense that it would be possible. Basically, what makes Japanese buildings so much different from European buildings, definitely in the way they look, is the fact that the windows and walls are often slidable, and windows aren't made of glass, at least not traditionally, but they often have this very thin paper in wooden frames as opposed to having glass in frames. And those like thin walls are basically very large windows in a sense, almost, for the buildings, and they make the look from the outside and from the inside very different. And it's something which I hadn't really done in the Japanese area yet, and I sort of felt bad about that because it's a very, very typical feature of Japanese houses. And in that sense, I felt the Japanese houses which I had so far, while I'm somewhat happy with it, are perhaps a bit too Western. Like, they still inevitably ended up being a bit more Western in overall design, especially with having so many windows. So I wanted to avoid all of the windows in this case, as much as I could in any case, and really get some typical Japanese townhouses, and that's the idea behind them. I did make them a little bit more fancy though. Many of the Japanese townhouses are just very much like the building on the left here, just the lower section with a roof, higher section and a roof above that, and just the Japanese typical looking walls. Not much beside that, but I did want to make them a little bit more interesting to look at than just that, and I guess also a bit more theme park Japanese-ish. So I did also take some inspiration from the samurai houses, things like that. And for instance, I also have this small gallery or the roof hanging over there with a small wooden floor that sort of sticks out above the path, which is not really as much a townhouse sort of thing, but more really one of those larger detached houses. I forgot the name for it, but it's something which many Japanese houses have around their entire perimeter, and it's something that I also wanted to get in here just to make it look a bit more interesting than just a flat building. And this building over here is really going to be the main eye catcher of the facade. What I always like to do, at least for me, what I find is quite nice for facades, is to always have this one facade that just sticks out from the rest, not just in heights, but also in general in details, and just be a little bit more complex than the rest of facades, as to sort of be a main draw for the facade in general. And I usually place it or them on the outsides, which is also what I wanted to do over here. But I really wanted this building to be the most detailed and just the most interesting building of the entire facade, because it is located right at the junction of all these paths over here. It's quite visible as you approach the Japanese area from the main street, but it's also very visible as you approach this area from the other side of the Japanese area. And I was really figuring it would be best to have this as a sort of the main, most detailed building of this facade in general. And it's also the one building which isn't as much inspired by the merchant buildings, but works quite well as a standalone detached building as well. So yeah, that's really the idea behind it. And aside from that, I did make it sort of from a reference. Like, I looked up many Japanese buildings just to see how certain things would look. So this is really just a mishmash of some roof shapes and just being a square building with wooden framework all over the four sides of it. But aside from that, it was just a lot of trying the different objects and see how they could really work together and just have fun in general with that. But yeah, this is, I wouldn't call it a weenie. It is far from a weenie, but the most intricate building of the main street. And on the other side, and this is how I often do my facades, the building on the other corner is also the main sort of detailed building. So the buildings in the corners, much like you would also see in a Disney main street, for instance, are just the most detailed and probably the biggest eye catchers of the facade, and the buildings in between them are sort of the fillers, and also the buildings that make it really look like it's this Japanese urban sort of setting in which this entire facade is placed. So yeah, that's basically just about that. And there are some other more specific detail choices that are probably worth going over. Most important is definitely the roof. If it weren't for this way that I sort of figured would be best to make roofs, I probably wouldn't have gone into these buildings at all, because really the roof was the most difficult obstacle really to overcome in making these buildings work. And the reason why I am much happier with this roof is not just because I feel it looks more like a tiled roof, but it's also just much more flexible in how you place it, much more easy to work around with and make these Japanese roof shapes and actually make it look clean. One of my biggest issues with the Japanese buildings so far is that they sort of look like a Japanese building in general, but you can tell that certain details are used for different uses than they're supposed to be. And it's all a little bit messy, like it doesn't fit together seamlessly. And that's what I really wanted to try and do here. Hence why also the bricks are much more useful, because it's such a small piece and you can just place it in so many tight corners and spaces. And I could use the concrete trims to cover up the empty areas between the sandstone that makes up the roof tiles, which is actually quite handy as well, because Japanese buildings are really intricately detailed and have lots of ornaments on them, which is mostly true for the very typical and well-known temples, which have these curvy roofs and lots of detail on them, but it's definitely true for the more standard houses as well. And what they all have is like these more detailed beams that go from the center, if you have a hip roof, for instance, to the corners. And it's something which I couldn't really get in with the Japanese buildings before, but it's such a big part of Japanese buildings and what sets their roofs, at least their tiled roofs, apart from many European tiled roofs. And it's something that I also wanted to get in here, so that's why I have all the white concrete beams on the roof over there. that sort of go toward the center of the building here. And another interesting thing, actually, is that the reason why I wanted to keep these buildings quite narrow and not really have any galleries alongside them or make them any single building too large is because realistically, Japanese townhouses are very narrow for a pretty good reason, which is actually quite funny, was quite funny to find out at least, which is that in Japan, supposedly, you were taxed for like how wide your house is and how much width of the street it occupies, hence why Japanese townhouses are very narrow at street level but then go on for miles behind that, which is quite similar to Dutch buildings very often as well, and definitely many European buildings too, which is quite funny and one of the reasons why realistically I wanted to make these buildings quite narrow. But then this building is a bit of sort of breaks the mold here, because it's much larger than the other buildings, much more intricately detailed, but that's just something I wanted to try. And then over here, I wanted to get some quick shoji screens in as well, which is a pretty important choice to make. Two, basically, they are those, they are the Japanese windows, like the wooden frames with the paper in them, to at least let some light through, but not have any windows in your building. Which are often slidable as well, I think, and you often see these slidable doors alongside them too. So I did want to keep some room open here and there for those screens and walls and doors to be slided into. But also I just wanted to create that general look of shoji walls in here as well, which is that very grid-like pattern of the wooden horizontal and vertical beams, which I'll actually add some different walls in later on just to add a bit more of a paper texture to them to make them look more like shoji screens, which I really wanted to do in here. And then this building is the ultimate filler building. It doesn't really have much going for it, but I needed toilets in the theme park, because I don't think I even have any toilets yet, which is pretty weird, and I just completely forgot about it. I just kept making buildings that wouldn't really work as toilets. But yeah, I really need some toilets in the park, obviously. So here goes, the toilets for the Japanese area. Aside from that, this facade isn't really much functional-wise. I would have loved to add a small gift shop or something along those lines over here, but in general, it's very hard to really make that work, and to do so would require a lot of imagination, and I don't think it would really quite be realistic. Like, what I would love to have is some small stands outside this building, a pretty inviting door with all sorts of merchandise, but it's obviously not possible, so I just wanted to focus on the facade instead and just have some toilets in there, because that's what it seemed best for and what I really needed in this area. So yeah, that's kind of underwhelming, I guess. It's a pretty large facade and I put a lot of effort into it, but in the end it's just a toilet building generally, so that's kind of weird. And yeah, obviously I just wanted to add this string of facades over here, not just to experiment with a different way of working on the Japanese theme, but also to make the Japanese theme actually be finished, or at least somewhat finished, and make that all come together to actually be able to finish this park. Because as I'll actually get into in the real-time part, which I do have at the end of this episode, just to show off this area of the park and the park in general a bit more, like, I really do want to start working toward making this park finished, and I'm not sure how much work I'm really going to still put into it, so anything that can help make the park look less unfinished and surrounded by just empty grassy fields is very appreciated and quite necessary, actually. So yeah, that's also why I wanted to get that in there. And last but not least, I wanted to add this small building over here, which is the final building of the facade. It's not too large. I may add one more building close to the restaurants, which I have in the Japanese area at the moment, and I might also add another building to the entrance of the Japanese area as you come from the main street. But aside from that, these are just about all of the Japanese buildings I want to do. And if I really want to get back to the area and work on more Japanese buildings, which I'm not sure if I'll ever have the time for it or if I'll ever want to really, it's something that I may do, and if I do so, it's going to be mostly because I want to maybe replace or revamp some of the current Japanese buildings that I have, because at the moment, because of adding these buildings here, the theme of Japan is pretty inconsistent. It's not too bad, like these buildings go somewhat okay with the buildings I already have, but I do like this style so much more, and I put a lot more thought and effort into these buildings, so I may want to make sure that it actually fits neatly and transitions seamlessly with the buildings that I already have in the area. But that's also something to maybe think about later if I still have some time left. So yeah, that's just about what I wanted to do here. This building, by the way, I have no exact idea what it is. Just wanted to try one more roof shape. I really wished it was easier to have like an actual curved roof, because funnily enough, curved roofs are seen as one of the most iconic parts of Japanese architecture, but they're really not that common, especially not in houses like this. And I figured I might get one curved roof in for just that house on the side there, but in the end it didn't really work out that well. Just wanted to add some extra details to the buildings, just to make them look a little bit more inviting, like some signs, as you see alongside Japanese, like merchant houses and things like that. Smaller details, stuff to look at, and replace some of the wood with different types of wood, to actually get an iconic, a visual effect, which I'll talk about a little bit more in the real-time part as well, so I'll save that. But this is really just some of the tweaking, which I don't commonly do in time lapses because it isn't as much a progression, but I really wanted to get it in here just because I wanted to tweak some things, and this was just in the middle of a time lapse, which is pretty cool anyway, because I wanted to also finish the backsides of these buildings really quickly here. Looking back though, this is probably too close to the entrance of the Alpine area on this side, though it isn't much of a really big issue because I can always move that path a little bit more. It is really close, but yeah, this is the backstage area, if you will, of the Japanese buildings. Just a couple of HVACs and stuff. I am no HVAC knowledgeable person, but I just wanted to get those in here just for the realistic look of making this a facade. Anyway, that's it for the time-lapse part. So I'm gonna skip to my real-time partner here. Alright, so this is how things look at the moment. I first want to take a bit of time to look at the Japanese houses, and afterwards a small overview of the park at the moment, because lots of people asked for that as well. But yeah, this is basically how the Japanese houses are looking at the moment. They're slightly different from the time-lapse, and that's also one of the reasons why I want to show them off a little bit more. I couldn't help myself from just adding some extra details in there and tweaking some things, not to mention some foliage, because foliage makes a really big difference, and I'll even remove some of the foliage, like what's behind here, at some point in the future to maybe add some extra buildings. But yeah, this is how things are looking at the moment. Here's the, I have no idea actually about this building. It's pretty damn big for the street, but like, I guess the rich person house. I wanted to have a different ceiling over here just to have some slightly different textures. Like, there is a lot of the same wooden texture and it might get very boring after a while. There's actually a sign hidden in here to just add a bit to that little detail on the top of the roof. But yeah, this is basically how the entire facade looks. I also wanted to add some quick signs over here. I think, yeah, I added some details over here to the signs just because I figured it would be nicer to add those. It's sort of trying to be those vertical scrolls that you see in some like Japanese merchant houses, but that's something that I couldn't really realistically get in and actually get to work with the pieces we have at the moment. But I figured this would go better than just leaving it completely empty. I also moved the toilet sign to where it actually belongs, to above the toilets there. So yeah, this is actually, I think, the first toilet building of the entire park, so that's kind of strange. But yeah, all that said, I do kind of like the look of the facades at the moment, and I'm actually really happy with how they came out. And I think in the end, they turned out much, much more realistic than the buildings that I had over here. Not to mention that there's that overwhelming shade of red, which works in the paths as well as the roofs in this area, and is one of the reasons why I may want to replace those roofs with these bricks from these buildings as well. It doesn't work as well. Like, I would really love to have some tiled roofs for realism purposes, and also be able to have black roofs as opposed to brown, because it's a really, really similar color to the shade of brown of the wooden posts and the wooden floors and things like that, which is kind of annoying. But aside from that, I think I'll just go with it and just replace some of these with bricks. I don't think I'll do the pagoda again because that already took hours, much like this pavilion actually, so I'll probably be lazy and just leave it the way it is, but I might return to it in the future. But that said, the deadline for this park is going to be the next alpha release, and well before the new alpha comes out, I would like to have this park finished and done and whip up a neat video of it. So I'm sort of on a deadline here, and I would rather actually focus on finishing the park first before I start, you know, looking at things again over here and just keep redoing the Japanese area. I'm actually quite happy with how the small pavilion turned out as well, though it's definitely much better in shape than it is in color. And it's also more of a Chinese thing. I just figured it would work pretty nicely in the Japanese area, and it's something that I really wanted to try. But obviously the white color isn't really that common, and I couldn't find any way to add decorative wooden beams over here. Like the bell towers, or the bells actually work really well for those decorative wooden beams on buildings like these, but kind of need a building behind them to be able to sink the bells into it, so that's kind of an issue. Also, I actually added some extra walls underneath like these things over here. Like I was really trying to get those shoji screens, and just keeping them white just like the rest of the walls didn't feel quite right. I don't know what's up with the little bit of glitching over here. Might want to look at that. So just decided to give them a slightly different color. Like it's supposed to look like the very thin paper framing that shoji screens have, but it's not that, I guess, convincing. I do really like the look of the building, but I guess what I'm struggling with is that as much as I have looked up on Japanese buildings, like I don't know exactly the way... whoops, that was almost my glass of water. I don't know exactly the way in which they like work together and how certain buildings are built. Like I can sort of emulate it, but I don't have the exact philosophy behind it. And while this is still a theme park, it shouldn't be too big of an issue, but it's a realism aspect that I'm perhaps missing out on. Anyway, that's it for the Japanese area, and the rest of the park is basically looking like this. It's quite finished, I should say. I'm not sure how much I'm really gonna do with this area, and this over here might as well just be left somewhat unfinished if it really has to be, if I'm really running out of time. But yeah, obviously the main street is a pretty big concern at the moment, and something that I would love to return to, because I'm not quite too sure what I want to do with the Roman area, and I had this with the Japanese area for such a long time and just didn't work on the park for 2 weeks, and I don't really want that to happen again. Like, I really feel like I want to work on something, and I want to get a really good idea of what I want to work on when I work on something. So I think I'll get to the main street and just emulate the buildings which I have on the main street already at the moment. Maybe make it a bit more wide, like it might become a little bit narrow the way it is at the moment. Whoops. Oh my god, this camera. And also, perhaps add some foliage to it, because it's sort of foliageless at the moment and it could use some greenery. But that's like one of the things I like to add in hindsight after all the buildings are already done, so that's something to work on at that point. I'm also not going to make this too large, like I won't completely connect it to the entrance and add many buildings to it. I think the main street is almost nearly halfway done. It's not going to be a Disney scale, it's just a sort of quick entrance area and like an area where you have like all the information and the first restaurants and things like that. So it's kind of, it looks nice, but it's sort of supposed to also be real theme park-ish functional. And then for the Roman area, I'm not quite sure what I want to do, but since I didn't really go over this yet, I think I should show it off a little bit. I tweaked the arch again, and I don't think it's quite shown in its current state in the time lapse. Like there are some really small tweaks. Nothing major, just some small details, but it is a bit different, I believe. And this is what it looks like at the moment. And, oh right, you did see the current version of the arch in the restaurant making episode, but I didn't really show it off well without a time-lapse, so here goes that. And my future plans are basically that I think I'll get a flat ride in this space, and I think it'll be like the Ursula-ish ride. I've no idea what it is, but she looks like Ursula. And probably like some sort of theater over here, kind of like Marco Polo's theater, not too big, just a simple theater, but the park doesn't have a theater yet, and what theme to use it in better than a Roman theme, I suppose. So that's sort of that plan, And then this area is still open for other ideas, but I don't really know if I have time for that. Besides, I'm looking forward way too much for the coming updates, but there are some other things I want to do in Planet Coaster, as well as in real life, obviously, and some other games I want to play, and in general life might screw me over. So I don't know if I'll really be able to get to this area too much. Might just want to fill it up with foliage at some point in time, just make it sort of part of the alpine area more or less, but not really do anything special with it. As much as I would like to try new themes, I'd rather focus now on making this park finished, because I'm quite happy with what I've already achieved. Not to mention that sort of what the Japanese area has shown is that even within a theme, and this goes for many themes, but especially for themes like Japanese and Roman, where you're really basing it on like a certain area's history, where there are so many different styles, like there are so many different ways in which you can make buildings within one theme, so much so that I would barely consider these buildings the same theme, because they're completely built in a different way. They just sort of have the same general aesthetic to them and are more or less Japanese, but so completely different. And this is much more experimental, so I'll still experiment quite a bit, but it should be more focused on making the park come together and finished and hopefully presentable by the time that the new alpha comes out. Anyway, I've been talking for way too long. This video is ridiculously large, so I'm sorry about that if you're not into long videos, but thank you for watching if you stayed all the way through the end. I commend your persistence of watching somebody play a video game for a pretty long time. But yeah, seriously, thank you so much for watching this episode. And next time, I'm going to do I Have No Clue, but it's probably going to be the main street. But don't be surprised if it isn't, because I'm pretty unpredictable.